back of the leg and the sole of the foot, the leg is divided by two intermuscular septa into three compartments. The septa attached anterior and posterior borders of the fibula. Anterior compartment or extensor muscles is formed by extensors with anterior tibial vessels and nerve. The anterior compartment lies anterior to the interosseous membrane. Lateral compartment or peroneal compartment is formed by two peroneal muscles together with the superficial peroneal nerve. It is found between two intermuscular septa and the lateral surface of the fibula. The posterior compartment or flexors is formed by flexor muscles together with the posterior tibial vessels and nerve. It lies posterior to the interosseous membrane. This is the two intermuscular septa anterior, and this is the posterior, dividing the muscles into three compartments. This is the anterior or extensor compartment, this is lateral or peroneal compartment, and this is posterior or flexor compartment. The muscles of the posterior compartment or calf muscles, these muscles are divided into superficial and deep groups by deep transverse fascia, between which posterior tibial vessels and nerve descends to the sole of the foot. The superficial group composed of gastrocnemius, plantaris, and soleus. The deep group is composed of popliteus muscle, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis longus, and tibialis posterior. The superficial muscles start with by gastrocnemius muscle, which arises by two heads. Medial head from the popliteal surface of the femur just above the medial condyle. Lateral head from the lateral surface of the lateral condyle of the femur. Insertion through the tendocalcaneus into the back of calcaneus. Nerve supply from tibial nerve by separate branch for each head. Action, it is powerful plantar flexor and also flexes the knee joint. Plantaris muscle arises from the popliteal surface of the femur just above the lateral condyle. It may be absent. Insertion by long slender tendon into the calcaneus. Nerve supply from the tibial nerve. Then soleus muscle origin from three areas, tibia, fibula, and the fibrous arch between them. The fibular origin from the back of the head of the fibula and the upper part of the shaft. Tibial origin from the soleal line and the middle of the medial border of the tibia. Then from fibrous arch between tibia and the fibula over the posterior tibial vessels and nerve. Insertion in the back of the calcaneus through the tendocalcaneus. Nerve supply by two branches from the tibial nerve. Action, it is major plantar flexor of the foot. This is the muscles of the posterior compartment. Gastrocnemius muscle, and this is the soleus muscle here. Deep muscles of the leg. Tibialis posterior muscle arises from the posterior aspect of the tibia, fibula, and the interosseous membrane. Insertion, the tendon passes deep to the flexor retinaculum to be inserted in the following. Number one, navicular bone. Number two, all tarsal bones except talus. Number three, the basis of middle three metatarsals. Nerve supply from posterior tibial nerve. Action, plantar flexion and inversion of the foot. The second muscle, flexor hallucis longus. Origin from the posterior aspect of the fibula, just below the origin of the soleus. Insertion, the tendon descends and passes in the second layer of the foot to be inserted in the terminal phalanx of the big toe. Nerve supply from posterior tibial nerve. Action, plantar flexion of the foot and deflection of all joints of the big toe. Flexor digitorum longus, origin from the posterior aspect just below the popliteus muscle. Insertion, the tendon passes deep to the flexor retinaculum and divided into four tendons to be inserted in the terminal phalanges of the lateral four toes. Nerve supply from posterior tibial nerve. Action, plantar flexion of the foot and deflexes the joints of lateral four toes. This is the deep muscles here, flexor hallucis longus. and this is flexor digitorum longus, and this is the tibialis posterior muscle. Plantar aponeurosis, this deep fascia at the sole of the foot thickened and condensed to form the plantar aponeurosis, which cover the flexor digitorum brevis. It is triangular in shape, the apex attached to the medial tubercle of the calcaneus. The base splits into 5 processes, 1 for each 2. Each process fuses with the proximal end of the fibrous flexor sheath, which lodges the tendons of the long and short flexors of the digits. From the margins of the plantar aponeurosis, medial and lateral septa extends deep on each side of flexor digitorum brevis, and this is the plantar aponeurosis. This is start from the calcaneus and divides into 5 slabs. The first and second layers of the sole of the foot. First layer is composed of 3 muscles: abductor hallucis medially, abductor digiti minimi laterally, flexor digitorum brevis in between. The second layer is composed of 2 tendons and 5 small muscles. Tendons of flexor hallucis longus passes to the big 2. Tendons of flexor digitorum longus passes to lateral 4 2s. Flexor digitorum accessorius attached to the tendon of flexor digitorum longus. Then 4 lumbrical muscles attached to the tendons of flexor digitorum longus and passing to lateral 4 2s. This is first and the second layers. The first layer, abductor hallucis, abductor digiti minimi, flexor digitorum brevis. The second layer is flexor hallucis longus for big 2, and this is flexor digitorum longus for lateral 4 2s. This is the flexor digitorum accessorius, and this is 4 lumbrical muscles. The third layer composed of 3 small muscles: flexor hallucis brevis medially, flexor digiti minimi laterally, adductor hallucis in between. The fourth layer is composed of 2 tendons and 7 small muscles. The tendons of tibialis posterior from the medial side, tendon of peroneus longus from the lateral side. Interosseous muscles are 3 plantar and 4 dorsal interossei. This is the third layer, the adductor here, and this is flexor hallucis brevis, flexor digiti minimi brevis, and this is the adductor hallucis. The fourth layer, from medial tendon of tibialis posterior, from lateral peroneus longus, and this is interossei muscles, 3 plantar and 4 dorsal interossei. Posterior tibial artery arises at the lower border of the popliteus as larger terminal of the popliteal artery. It descends between the 2 venae combatants to end deep to flexor retinaculum by dividing into medial and lateral plantar arteries. Branches, circumflex fibular artery passes laterally around the neck of the fibula. Peroneal artery, it is the largest branch and arises below the popliteus muscle. It descends between and laterally along the medial crest of the fibula. It gives nutrient artery to the tibia. Medial calcaneal branch versus the flexor retinaculum. Terminal, medial and lateral plantar arteries deep to the flexor retinaculum. This is the posterior, this is the popliteal artery at the lower border of the popliteus muscle. Gives the 2 terminals, posterior tibial directed backwards and anterior tibial directed forwards. From the posterior tibial, a large branch arises called peroneal or fibular artery. The peroneal artery gives many branches, nutrient artery to the fibula, perforating branches perforates the lower part of the interosseous membrane and directed forwards to the dorsum of the foot. If the dorsalis medius artery is absent, it is replaced by perforating branch of the peroneal artery. Then lateral calcaneal branch arises as the terminal branch of the peroneal artery. Again, this is the posterior tibial and this is the peroneal or fibular artery. Plantar arteries, medial plantar and the lateral plantar arteries arises deep to the flexor retinaculum at two terminals of the posterior tibial artery. The medial branch passes together with the medial plantar nerve between first and second layers of the sole of the foot. Lateral plantar artery accompanies the lateral plantar nerve between first and second layers till the base of the fifth metatarsal bone. It curves medially towards the base of the first metatarsal bone between third and fourth layers to form the plantar arch, where it joins the termination of dorsalis pedis artery. The plantar arch gives three plantar metatarsal arteries to the lateral three interosseous spaces. Three posterior perforating arteries, this passes upward to join the dorsal metatarsal arteries. This is the lateral plantar artery here, curved to the medial to form the plantar arch. Posterior tibial nerve starts at the lower border of the popliteus muscle as continuation of the tibial nerve. It ends deep to the flexor retinaculum by dividing into medial and lateral plantar nerves. It gives the branches, number one, muscular branches to the posterior group of muscles, the back of the leg, then tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis longus. Then cutaneous branches to supply the heel, articular branches to the ankle joints, terminal branches, medial and lateral plantar. This is the posterior tibial nerve, divides deep to the flexor retinaculum into two terminals, medial and lateral plantar nerves. The plantar nerves, lateral plantar passes in the sole of the foot between first and second layers. Branches of lateral plantar nerve cutaneous to the skin of the lateral part of the sole of the foot, muscular to abductor and flexor digiti minimi, flexor digitorum accessorius. Articular branches to intertarsal and tarso metatarsal joints. Medial plantar nerve arises deep to flexor retinaculum at one of the two terminals of the posterior tibial nerve. Branches, number one, cutaneous to the skin of the medial part of the sole of the foot. Muscular to abductor hallucis, flexor hallucis brevis, flexor digitorum brevis, and the first lumbrical muscle. This is the plantar nerves, this medial plantar, and this is lateral plantar nerve, and this is the cutaneous supply from different nerves for the sole of the foot. This is the area for lateral plantar nerve, and this is for medial plantar nerve, and this is the heel tibial nerve.